Warning: sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid are corrosive. Wear gloves when handling them. Diethyl ether is highly volatile and highly flammable. Work in a fume hood and fire safety protocols must be in place. Greetings, fellow nerds. You've seen me destroy aluminum with gallium in various videos, and some of you have asked how to recover it from the spent aluminum. In a previous video, I showed an easy method using sodium hydroxide decomposition that essentially destroys the aluminum but leaves the gallium behind. You can check the video description for that video. Now, this method does work, and for the amateur, this is probably all you need. But a lot of gallium is destroyed as well, so recovery isn't very good. In this video, we're going to use a solvent extraction method to recover even more gallium. The idea is that we're going to selectively dissolve gallium chloride in diethyl ether, but not aluminum chloride. This allows us to concentrate the gallium for easier recovery. To show you how effective this is, I'm going to use the spent waste from the previous video. It looks like a great deal more than what I had in that video because this also includes runs which didn't work. Now, we already removed the recoverable gallium from this, so this should be depleted. Let's see how much gallium we can recover with this solvent extraction method. Now, this waste is mostly aluminum oxide as well as sodium hydroxide and tiny amounts of gallium hydroxide. First, we'll need to neutralize all of it with concentrated hydrochloric acid. It's bubbling because it's releasing carbon dioxide. It absorbed a lot while sitting at the back of my lab for the last couple of months. What we want is to convert all the metal oxides and hydroxides into their chloride salts. Aluminum, gallium, and sodium chloride. Keep adding hydrochloric acid until it stops bubbling. It's not clear yet because at room temperature the conversion to aluminum and gallium chloride is rather slow. Transfer the mixture to a glass container and heat it on the hot plate. As it heats up, it will drive the reaction forward and clear up. If the solution boils but is still not clear, then you'll need to add in more hydrochloric acid. The yellow color you see here is iron contamination. Aluminum metal tends to have very tiny amounts of iron in it. It's not a problem for most purposes, but iron chloride will give a strong yellow color like this. Anyway, once everything is dissolved, let it cool. Now, as it cools, it may crystallize out excess aluminum and sodium chlorides. This is not a problem as what we really want, the gallium chloride, will remain in solution. Now, filter out the mixture. This is to get rid of the crystallized salts and also get rid of the various paint chips that came with the aluminum softball bat we originally performed our experiment on. And here we have it, a solution of aluminum and gallium chlorides. Now, place this in the fridge and cool it down further. We're doing this because we'll be performing a solvent extraction with ether later, and a cold solution will help prevent evaporative losses. And here we are after leaving the solution in the fridge overnight. You can see even more of the aluminum chloride crystallizing out. Now, you're going to need a large separatory funnel. We fill it halfway, in my case 500 milliliters, with diethyl ether. I got most of mine distilling it off starter fluid as shown in a previous video. Diethyl ether has a low boiling point of just 34.6 degrees Celsius, so on a hot day like today you can lose a lot just from evaporation. It's also a tremendous fire hazard being so volatile and flammable, so when doing extractions it's a good idea to pre-chill it in the fridge if you can. This helps to keep the vapors under control. Okay, now that the ether is in there, we add the solution of aluminum chloride. Now, once it's in there, put the cap on and shake it up to perform the extraction. Now, this is where the actual important part is happening. Gallium and aluminum chlorides are both highly soluble in water, but gallium chloride is also soluble in diethyl ether. So by shaking them together, we can transfer gallium chloride from the water to the ether and leave behind aluminum chloride. This allows us to tremendously concentrate and purify the gallium from the aluminum. Okay, after a few minutes of shaking, let the contents settle and drain out the bottom aqueous layer. This should be depleted in gallium chloride. Keep the upper organic layer of ether. Now, I have a lot more solution, so now I'm going to add another 500 milliliters of it to the ether and extract more gallium chloride. Now, you professional chemists are probably yelling at the screen right now. Extracting it this way is not as efficient as using fresh ether with fresh solution. I'm doing it this way because this is all the diethyl ether I have, so I have to reuse the same amount. I'm not going to recover all the gallium possible, but at least we'll have enough to demonstrate the process. Anyway, once again drain off the aqueous layer and extract more solution until you've gone through it all. And here it is, a solution of ether and gallium chloride. The yellow color is from small amounts of iron chloride, which is also slightly soluble in ether. Now we need to remove the ether. Simply set up for distillation and distill it off. Stop distilling when no more ether transfers over at its boiling point. You can actually reuse the ether and extract again the aluminum and gallium solution for maximum recovery. I didn't do that because I didn't have the time. Now I went a little too far with my distillation and charred my residue, but this isn't a problem. Now at this point we have a syrup of gallium trichloride, residual water, and ether. Gallium chloride actually binds ether pretty strongly, so distilling it off is actually pretty hard. We need to get it back into water solution, so add in about twice its volume of water. The separation of layers shows that the ether hasn't fully distilled off. Just put it back into distillation and distill off the ether until water starts distilling. The ether now distills off easily because the gallium chloride can bind with water instead of ether. Now at this point we have a solution of gallium chloride and water. Now add in small amounts of sodium hydroxide, about 5% of the solution mass at a time. At first it will form a precipitate of gallium hydroxide. But as you keep adding sodium hydroxide, it will dissolve again as the sodium hydroxide and gallium hydroxides react to form a sodium gallium hydroxide. It is this stuff that we want, so keep going until the precipitate dissolves again. Now at this point I made a major fail. I added in too much sodium hydroxide at once and the solution got so hot that it boiled over. All that work destroyed in the blink of an eye. This was the kind of mistake I yelled at my students for doing back when I was a chemistry TA. Now people keep telling me to post my failures so you can learn from them. All you're really learning is that I am an idiot. I'm certain you already knew that a long time ago. Anyway, there is still a small amount left that we can still work with, so I'm going to clean up and keep going, but we're going to have very bad gallium recovery. Here is the solution with all the gallium hydroxide we dissolved. I added a bit of water so I would have more volume to work with. The black suspension is iron hydroxides that also precipitated out and did not redissolve. I want to filter them out, but they passed right through my filter paper. I don't have a finer filter, so we're just going to have to go to the next step anyway. Now to recover the actual gallium metal, we set up for electrolysis. On the right over here is a platinum anode. You can also use nickel since we're working in strongly alkaline conditions. On the left here is a titanium cathode. But you can also use copper, nickel, steel, and most other metals that are stable in alkaline conditions. Now we run enough current until the cathode just starts to bubble. This is where we're producing gallium metal. At the anode we're mostly generating oxygen, although there will be some chloride electrolysis as well. The whole solution is being gently heated to 40 degrees Celsius so the gallium actually drips off the cathode as a liquid. The suspended iron particles are blocking our view, which is why I wanted to remove them, but you can make out droplets of gallium metal forming. I think it's amazing to actually see a liquid metal electrolyze out of solution. Now you might be asking why we didn't do the electrolysis on the bulk waste. This is because the gallium concentration is far too low. We need the solvent extraction to separate and concentrate the gallium so that it would be recoverable by electrolysis. Anyway, keep electrolyzing until no more gallium deposits out. And there we have it, gallium metal recovered by solvent extraction and electrolysis. It doesn't look like much, but keep in mind that this was what the sodium hydroxide method could not recover. This was done on the waste. And this method was also a failure. If a failure gives results this good, imagine how much I would have gotten if I actually did this right. For comparison, this is the same gallium nugget recovered by a simple reaction with sodium hydroxide. I think I would have gotten an equal amount if I hadn't screwed up. So when recovering gallium you have two options. You can use the sodium hydroxide reaction as shown in a previous video, which is quick and easy. But if you're willing to put in the work, you can instead react your aluminum metal with hydrochloric acid and use solvent extraction with ether as shown in this video for vastly improved recovery. Assuming of course you didn't mess up like I did. Thanks for watching. Special thank you to all of my supporters on Patreon for making these science videos possible with their donations and their direction. If you're not currently a patron but would like to support the continued production of science videos like this one, then check out my Patreon page here or in the video description. I really appreciate any and all support.